Hello, Mary Meat. So I want to review a book, and the book I want to review is this one, Advanced Flying Stars Feng Shui by Steven Skinner. And it is published by Golden Horde. And this is, I am actually not sure which edition, but it is the newest edition of this book. And the newest edition gets a little bit costly, but there are cheaper older editions available. So, let's have a look at the content. And yes, I'm interested in Feng Shui. Ironic as that might be from the state of my apartment, I think that with the amount of mess that's here, a Feng Shui master that came into this place would probably die. So, yes. I better not invite Steven Skinner here for tea. I am planning at some point of doing something about it, but for now I enjoyed reading about it. But anyway, we have contents. We have a list of figures and a list of tables, which I always like it when they make lists of that available, so it's easy to navigate the book. We have acknowledgements and an introduction. And then we have Feng Shui theory, and Feng Shui and the calendar, reading the, and I'm going to butcher it because when it comes to pronunciations, reading the Lu Pam compass. It's Lu Pam, isn't it? Well, it's this thing here. Very important in Feng Shui. Reconciling flying stars with eight mansions Feng Shui. It's basically two theories of it. Taoist cosmology. I love that section. I really, really, really loved it. The flying stars, and we're not really thinking here about the flying stars as weapons that you throw at people, basically star-shaped drawing daggers. It's the name of the type of. It's an idea within Feng Shui here, not actual weapons. It's something else. And then you have individual flying stars. Then you have matching the building, placing the Lao Shao over the building floor plan. I really like that. It's a way to figure out how you can get the balance within a home. Even here it would be get rid of some of all this shit. This little compass here would tell me, would scream it to me, and I wouldn't listen to it, so yes. Applying the lotion to the interior. Then you have flying stars, which basically explains that concept. You have the flying stars, keys to interpretation, combining the flying star, flying star contributions, and visiting stars. It's basically, yes, various forms of energetic and astrological impacts, and various other such things that have an effect on Feng Shui. Then you have dealing with the annual wild stars, and you have substitute stars at Kua boundaries, specific chart patterns and overall configurations. Cross palace formulae, corrections and remedies, arranging the six matters, water formulae usable with the flying stars, relating the flying stars to the physical landscape, and summary of methods. And then we have appendixes, which is how to fly the stars, full method, history of the masters of flying star, short biography of Shen Shu Reng, Chinese dynasties and Feng Shui chronology. Purple-white method of dividing the great cycle, comparison of the Western and Chinese calendars, which can be quite useful when working with Feng Shui, comparison of the Western, a word about Chinese transliteration, flying star and eight mansions formulae on the Lopan, all flying star chart and substitute star charts. So yeah, it's a form of basically mixing astrology and feng shui, which basically these within the Taoist ideology, these things do naturally come together. So it's a pretty advanced book. This is not the typical fluffy book on feng shui that you will find in your local bookstore that are named things like clear your space, improve your life, or get better sex by feng shuiing up your bedroom, or whatever these books are called. Not that there's anything wrong with them, I have several of those and they are quite useful, but these do go more in depth about the origins of the system and also are more original. However, as such, it is pretty scholarly, so this isn't the kind of book that I would normally sit down with when I've had a long, hard day and I just want to relax and read something, because it gets a bit complicated. And to be quite honest, I am not no expert in feng shui. It's a topic that interests me, but it is not something that I have gone extremely in depth with, and the book is probably a bit too advanced for my level as well, though I have read quite a bit of other areas within things that touch on Taoism, and also studied Taoism itself for a while. There are quite a few things that go over my head there, but it is extremely informative. This is a very, very good book. Though, as it is costly, I do recommend waiting to get it until it goes down in price, because these books usually do. Or going for an earlier edition. With a book this costly, it's generally have to also review the quality of the book itself. It is very well made. It has bookmark, which I just left as I was reading it where it was, because I generally prefer to use other bookmarks than those. I do not like these stickers they have put all over. I think they have one there too, because it ruins an otherwise very nice dust cover. The back also have a lot of advertisements for other books by the publisher. And it has imprints in gold, and it's a decently well-made book. The reason also, because many people, when they see prices of these books like this, I think this costs $60, they go insane over it. But here's the thing, this is not, let me just get the dust cover proper, there we go. This is not the kind of book that will attract most buyers, because the get better sex with feng shui in the bedroom is going to sell a lot more copies, because it's going to interest a lot more casual readers. I am very interested in everything that has to do with Taoism, and especially when it comes to qi and energy manipulation. So for me, the book is worth it, even if I don't practice feng shui itself a lot. But it definitely is not necessarily a book that is targeted at the casual reader. But it is very, very good. It is well written. And while it gets pretty advanced, and it do, in several sections do need several read tos to get it, and the author do a very good job at teaching. So for me, the cost was definitely worth it. There are these pictures in it, not a lot of them, but there are some. And yeah, it's, but I mean, the information is awesome, and there's just so many things here that you wouldn't necessarily find other places, like how Feng Shui ties in with quite a few historical figures, astrological charts. It's how to adjust various things between Western and these ideas. You can see some of the ideas behind the flying stars. Think of them if you're gonna. I might do a video on them if anybody is interested. The theory behind it, because that gets. I mean, if I'm gonna start to explain that, that is an old video in itself. But. Yes. I can do a video on that, and I will just say that it explains it very well. It explains how to use this mirror that whose names I can never pronounce, and basically gives you what you need to practice Feng Shui and do it fairly well. I am impressed by the book. I really like it. So yeah. I don't know really what more I can say about it, because it's one of those books I don't really have any complaints. It goes through the material very well. It's definitely scholarly. You have to expect with when reading this one that you read a bit of it and you put it down to digest the material and perhaps reread sections. It's not one of those that you, oh well, I have a few hours, I'll sit down and read a book and with a cup of tea in one hand and some music on and just relax, because this is something that you have to, this book is more what you have to study than just read for amusement. But yeah, it's good. It teaches the material well, it's well written, there's lots of information here. Now, since I am not very familiar with Feng Shui at this level, I cannot say if there's any mistakes made, so you have to take that into account when you are watching this review, that I am not the most advanced practitioner, so I can't tell you if there are mistakes. I didn't find any that from my experience, but that isn't so great, so yeah, there could be, but not that I found. I found it to be a very informative, well-written, thoughtful book, and I definitely do recommend it. And I also think that if you like those more down-to-earth, practical, just get things done, westernized Feng Shui books, I think that a book like this will help you get more out of a book like that as well. So yeah, it can be seen as a key to just make any kind of Feng Shui work more powerful. And yeah, that is my review of Advanced Flying Star Feng Shui by Stephen Skinner by Golden Horde Publishing. I hope you have enjoyed this review. Have a great day and blessed be.